What's going on, everyone? Jeremy here from The Quartering, here with the 7 o'clock video. If you missed my first two, I covered the Avengers actress receiving some weird interactions from people online. I also covered at the 4 o'clock hour the Call of Duty, former boss of the Call of Duty game, alleging that Activision is pushing the new developer to make the game controversial or whatever the case may be. And now here we are at 7, covering a wonderful, wonderful story that is of one of equality. That's right. Gaming company Razer drops streamer for calling men trash. Now, what is Razer? Well, they make like peripherals, mice, keyboards. They're definitely big in the eSports scene, and I'm probably out in front of the story. I'm going to bet that we're going to see a big backlash of this. If we don't, it'll be because it happened in Brazil. I'm not totally sure, but they refer to what the word she used as extreme. Gabriella Catuzzo, or Catuzzo, I don't know, we'll just call her Gabby, a streamer who primarily broadcasts on Facebook from Brazil, has since posted on Twitter that she's stepping away from social media after her personal information was posted online. Now, of course, I disavow this type of thing. People always take things too far, and it's just unfortunate. You can disagree with something that somebody says just because they are a public figure doesn't give you the right to do that kind of stuff. I mean, obviously, I've had that happen to me several times, and it is a bit unnerving, and you get used to it after a while, but at the same time, like, it's just out of bounds, you know? Gabby, a streamer who primarily broadcasts on Facebook from Brazil, has been dropped by gaming peripheral maker Razer's influencer program after she tweeted, quote, "men are trash," which Razer Brazil counted as extreme. Last week, Catuzzo tweeted a photo of herself riding a mechanical bull, to which a user on Twitter replied, "you can ride me as much as you like." Catuzzo responded by saying, "there's always some jerk to say stuff and, look at women in a spicy way, even when women are making a joke, right? That's why men are trash." She later added, "non-poopy men are the exception. So the rule is that men are bad. And not the majority." Catuzzo tweets were originally written in Portuguese and have since been deleted. The Twitter user's original tweet are still online. The tweet went viral, and Catuzzo began receiving, of course, it's harassment online. Of course, right? Now, when you say something like that, you are going to aggravate, you're going to rile up a lot of people. This is an interesting situation because I'm obviously a huge feminist, big into the feminism scene, and I want everything to be equal. And so I think if a man had tweeted the same thing, they would have been dropped like a red hot pan on the floor and kicked out into the yard. I am absolutely sure. So to see Razer take exception in this way, it becomes a story because I don't know if we'd see the same thing in the Western market here in the United States. It seems like this type of attitude, in my opinion, is celebrated. And if you go against that type of attitude, then you are also on the receiving end of a lot of things, negative things online. The tweet went viral, and she started receiving, blowback online, including on the Brazilian forum called Dogo Lachan. During this time, Catuzzo's dissenters posted clips of an old Twitch stream where she trash talks a viewer and asks the question, Then she has since apologized for those comments. On June 24th, Razer posted a statement on Twitter addressing the situation. Razer Brazil reinforces that the opinion of its influencers do not reflect necessarily the opinion of the business, which is totally against any type of discrimination, be it on any format. I love it. I don't have any Razer products. I have a Logitech mouse, Sound Blaster speakers, Corsair. I feel like I should buy something from Razer now. Now, I'm going to be watching very closely because as this story begins to spread, as hopefully you've liked this video and written in the comment section down below, which I hope that you have and that you've considered sharing it online. This is the correct response, all right? I think what she said was inappropriate, and if a man had said the same thing, they would deserve the exact same treatment. I mean, if you are a brand that, I mean, let's just get down to the brass tacks of it, the actual facts, okay? The people that buy Razer computer peripherals, high-end gaming mice and keyboards, yes, there are women that buy them, but I would be willing to bet you that it's 80 to 90% male. Yes, I don't have any facts to back that up, but in the competitive gaming scene, we can assume that we could take a look at the floor of competitive gamers and pick out just, you know, a regular percentage. I don't think normies are buying Razer mice. This is for the high impact or the competitive player or the wannabe competitive player, which historically is predominantly men. So the message is obviously, you know, it's bad enough on its own. And I think insert whatever you want in there is not what I would want my influencers saying. But let's be real, this is definitely going to be perceived as a negative slant at your primary customer base. That can't stand. Apparently in Brazil, they still understand that the customers are always right. Now, the company representative wrote, "We have been since the beginning as gamers confronted with all types of preconceptions and stereotypes. And we will continue to fight it so this type of situation won't repeat itself." In other words, gamers are the most oppressed people on the planet. I love it. I love it. Good for you, Razer. Seriously, excellent behavior from the company. Razer said that they would not renew her contract when it expired next week. Ahead of Razer's post, Catuzio apologized for reacting to the Twitter user's comment, but noted that she's not sorry for defending herself. In an earlier tweet, she explained that most of my comments I receive are criticisms linked to being a woman and not other factors, she wrote. She added that the most of the comments she receives on the social media are like that. You know, I do believe that this can be true, that, you know, you might, I'm sure that women face more of that than men. I don't think it's okay. And I wish people would keep things on topic, but that's not the case. And you see, the coverage, though, has been, you know, overwhelmingly in the support of this female. Razer publicly shames female influencer who tweeted about being harassed. The Brazilian branch Razer, this video gaming accessory maker, has announced that it will terminate a contract. According to a Twitter longer post translated by Google and later confirmed by a Portuguese speaker working with the Daily Dot, made by influencer Gabby Catuzzo. The incident began when a comment made. So essentially some dude said something inappropriate and she blew her stack. I don't think that either person was correct in this state, but here's the thing. There are a lot of people that will say unfortunate things to me on Twitter. I generally respond to them, or in fact, I will retweet them, but I'm also not a representative of a company. And I realize that once you sign up for that, it's like I talk about when you have developers out there with the, you know, Jessica Price, get woke, go broke. You know, when you have prominent developers at your company using your company name in their Twitter bio for clout and to get certified blue check marks on Twitter and things like that, whether they say in their profile or not that, you know, their opinions are their own, they are not anymore. They are at least lightly associated with your company. And when you're going to put these type of comments out there, it's going to reflect poorly on your company. In this case, it's Razer Peripherals. She said, "Men is trash, and those that are not are exceptions," she wrote in a post, referring to the comment from 2017 in her post. "My intention with this phrase was, whenever I put something in, when I have to leave a 1% gap to be made a bad joke. I mean, a lot of men go there and do it. 90% of the comments are usually made by men. If you did not go there and made a joke, congratulations, you are the exception. I thank you for that. The intention was never to be misandrist, much less curse all men, even because I said there were exceptions. Please understand, I post pictures every day, and every day most comments are offensive." You know, and okay, this is a tough spot, right? I mean, I think you'd be better to just block those type of people that make that comment. I think eventually you'd get through it. But, you know, it's interesting when you look, you know, I'm not familiar with this person. I don't see a lot of, you know, I don't know what I would say, spicy photos. But, I mean, certainly you are posting, you know, like photo shoot type pictures, you know. You have what? You have your own Old Spice now? I mean, I don't know. I don't see a lot of Razer promotion here. I see a lot of just selfies and stuff like that. But nothing, I would say, well, you know, I mean, there's some, you know, again, she has every right to post the pictures that she wants. Absolutely. I don't think that I would put her in the, I don't know, far category of what you might see from Amaranth or something like that on Twitter. But, you know, it is an unfortunate side effect. But again, I think that you do, when you want to put that out there, you're going to have some people, it's the public space, and you're going to have some people say some unsavory things. This is why I rarely post pictures of my wife. There's absolutely nothing that says I can't. But, you know, I just know how people are. And I'm not going to try to live in this world where, you know, that people will never say mean things or people will never, you know, that's just not the reality of things. Of course, it would be ideal if nobody, you know, made like, that's what she said joke kind of thing. That doesn't offend me, but you get what I'm saying. I guess I have to give props here to Razer. I don't think they publicly shamed her. I think they responded to an obvious situation that needed to be responded to. And, you know, it's important that we remember that if this was the other way around, if a man had said that about women, the reaction would have been swift and far worse. So what's good for the goose is good for the gander. Hope you enjoyed this video. We'll talk to you again real soon.